This week at NASA. The next hardware package to fly to the International Space Station was unveiled to reporters at the Kennedy Space Center. The Permanent Multipurpose Module, or PMM, will carry spare parts and supplies to the ISS. Once delivered by Space Shuttle Discovery and installed on the station, the PMM will be used for microgravity experiments in fluid physics, materials science, biology, and biotechnology. Commander Steve Lindsay and his five STS-133 crewmates will also have some interesting company aboard Discovery. Robonaut 2, or R2, a dexterous human-like robot capable of handling a wide range of EVA tools and equipment, will also be shuttled to the complex. Discovery is targeted to launch on November 1st. A chunk of ice about 97 square miles in size has broken off the Peterman Glacier along the northwestern coast of Greenland. The glacier lost about one quarter of its 40-mile-long floating ice shelf, the largest in the northern hemisphere. It's not unusual for large icebergs to calve off the Peterman Glacier, but this new one is the largest to form in the Arctic in 38 years. This before and after visualization comes from imagery captured by instruments on NASA's Aqua and Terra satellites. Segway inventor and TV host Dean Kamen was at the Langley Research Center to interview engineer and inventor Mark Moore for his Discovery Network series, Dean of Invention. Moore is the co-creator of the Puffin aircraft, a vehicle that flies one person with two electric motors. Kamen and Moore strolled the Langley campus, displayed a 1/3 scale model of Puffin, and spent time with its simulator. Scientists say that at a height of 12 feet with a wingspan of 13.5 feet, the Puffin and its rechargeable lithium phosphate batteries has the potential to revolutionize commuter travel by providing an alternative to driving on overcrowded streets. Moore will appear in the 8th and final episode of Kamen's show. Kamen, who is also the founder of First Robotics, a national competition of high school students, holds 440 U.S. and foreign patents, and in 2000 was awarded the National Medal of Technology.
This flag is to the citizens of Palmdale. It's presented to the mayor and to the citizens.
A municipal flag flown on Space Shuttle Atlantis during STS-132 was presented to the city of Palmdale, California, during its weekly Thursday Nights on the Square activity.
The city of Palmdale flag was flown aboard the Space Shuttle Atlantis to the International Space Station during STS-132, traveling more than 4.8 million miles and 186 orbits of the Earth.
It's a great partnership that we have with the city of Palmdale. I see it to continue. It'll continue to prosper over the years. And it's just a great time to be here. And I just see wonderful things happening in the future.
The flag and a plaque depicting highlights of the STS-132 mission to the International Space Station will be on permanent public display.
The Janice C. Meyer Award for Exceptional Merit is this float sponsored by the NASA Glenn Research Center.
Atop the Glenn Research Center float depicting Space Shuttle Discovery, astronaut Leland Melvin waved to the crowds at the 2010 Pro Football Hall of Fame Festival Timken Grand Parade in Canton, Ohio.
Tried out for a couple NFL teams.
Before coming to NASA, Melvin was selected out of the University of Richmond by the Detroit Lions in the National Football League's 1986 college draft. He later participated in the Toronto Argonauts and Dallas Cowboys football training camps. A veteran of two space shuttle flights, Melvin is traveling around the country in support of NASA's Summer of Innovation program to excite young people about careers in science, technology, engineering, and math. And that's this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, log on to www.nasa.gov.